my child, and I have a son, my objective, our objective is to, here's one of those old Adventist phrases, raise him, you know, in the fear and admonition of the Lord, right? So I want him to respect God. I want him to love God. And I want him to love people. Jesus said, I can sum the whole thing up in this, that you know, love for God and love for others. All this is the whole law. This is the whole bowl of wax, in a sense. So part of that love relationship involves the way we relate. So I have to model it. I can't just give him principles and say, hey, this is what you're supposed to do. And then, you know, in practice, I'm doing something different. And I struggled with this. I'm not there yet. My wife would tell you that in a minute. You are not there yet. You know, let's just be clear. But hopefully I'm modeling something that he can see that will help him in the conflicts that and relationships that he has with other people. You know, there's a principle. We're talking about how to have difficult conversation. There's a principle that I loved, and it comes from the Apostle Paul. Now, Jesus, of course, tells us that love is the basis of all that we're supposed to do, right? By this people know. This is how people will believe. Is in the unity that you guys have. It's in the love you share for one another. That's the thing that will drive home truth, not your pronouncements and your pontifications, good as they are, not your theology and your understanding. It is going to be the love quotient, the love level, the temperature. All right. So Paul has a way. Now, Paul is speaking to churches where he's got to say hard things. He says hard stuff. You know, hey, Corinthians, you all got every kind of sexual immorality going on. Y'all got to quit that, you know, or he's speaking to the Roman church or other believers, and he's got to say hard things. So how does Paul do it? This is one of my strategies. Paul always finds something to praise first. What I'm saying is the conversation, when it's difficult, is not the totality of who the person is or the situation is. So let's not make it everything. Okay, we disagree, and here's one of those hot button topics we're not gonna talk about. We disagree about LGBTQ issues in the church. Yeah. We will not have this conversation, right? But the people we are in conversation with, they are not just one dimensional, and neither are we. And is there anything that can be praised? Is there anything that can be encouraged? You know what? Philippians, Ephesians, man, I just love the way you care for the brethren. You know, I've got this thing against you, but can I just share with you what I love about you? And I find that can create an atmosphere that is healthy for good. There are other things that is healthy for good conversation. Begin by affirming the good before you point out the bad.